This is actually a step-by-step walkthrough, which will cover these 14 important topics with hands-on coding. I have covered everything you need to learn to work with single-dimensional array efficiently on your day-to-day job. And I assure you, if you watch all these short videos, you won't need any other video or tutorial on these topics again. Welcome, I'm from CodeBuns. In today's video, I'm going to be taking a look at single-dimensional array in C#. In my next video will be on the C# rectangular array. So keep watching. Please subscribe to this channel and make sure to hit the bell icon to receive notifications of my latest videos. So, what is single-dimensional array? You can think of this array as a numbered list of items. This number is referred to as item index, or you can say item key in the array. And with the help of this number index, you access each item in the array. Remember this, index will always be a numeric value, a number. Actually, array stores multiple values of the same type. I repeat, it stores multiple values of the same type in a single variable, like this array of integer values, string values, etc. Single dimensional array is also called one dimensional or 1D array. It's up to you, whatever you name it. Suppose this is the array, and these boxes are the array elements, or you can say array items. I will use the word items interchangeably with the elements. Now, if I add 8 elements of the same type in this array, like integer values from 1 to 8, then their indexes will be from 0 to 7. The index of the first element of an array always starts with 0. The index of the second element is 1, and so on. But the index of the last element is always 1 less than the total number of elements in the array. The smallest index is called lower bound. And the largest index is called upper bound. I'm talking about the index here, this part. So don't mix it with the array elements or values. Now is the important part. If you try to use an index that's greater than the upper bound, in this case, an index of 8, C# compiler will throw index out of range exception. It's a type of error. Let's start with the syntax. You can create an array using one or two statements. To declare an array, you first define the type of items you want to store in the array. Now, these items can be integer, float, double, string, etc. Followed by empty opening and closing square brackets. Now, I give the array a name. Name of the array is usually plural because array is a collection of items. Name like movies, fruits, ages, countries, etc. However, this statement only declares the variable. It doesn't yet initialize an array. You do the initialization part with the new keyword, followed by the data type, and a second set of square brackets containing the length or size of an array. Now, this statement creates an array object. Basically, array is a reference type, an object. So, with the initialization statement, memory on the heap, which is a dynamic memory, is allocated to hold the elements of an array. This length is the fixed number of elements that the array can hold. And once array initialized with the values using this statement, then this length cannot be changed. That means you cannot increase or decrease the size of an array. It's a fixed size. I will explain everything in the demo, so don't worry if you miss something. Pay attention. When you initialize the array with this statement, the default value is automatically assigned to the array elements for that data type. Suppose you declared and initialized an integer array with the length of 4. When you access the array and try to print the values, you get 4 zeros out of the array. Why is that? Because the default value of int type or integer type is 0, which is automatically assigned to the array elements when you initialized it with this line of code. You can use another way to declare and initialize the array at the same time on a single line like this. I'm going to use this C# online editor for the demo. You can find the link in the description. Let's declare an array first. Here I have just declared a variable called int values, and it's an integer array. In order to use this array, I need to initialize it. Let me do that. I have initialized the array with the new keyword, followed by the data type, and a set of square brackets. Click run. This will generate error. Why is that? Because you need to tell how large you want the array to be during the initialization time. I say 4. I have just defined an integer array with the size of 4. Now this array can hold 4 elements of integer type. I already told you, once array is created, then this length cannot be changed. You can combine both these statements together, meaning declaration and initialization at the same time on a single line like this.